Hi guys, what's up? Good morning. So yeah, I'm going to try my week in a day. I'm going to try to do film everything I do in a week. Today is all about like editing and stuff. I don't have much to do. But look at my skin though. Like if you want to see a quick routine, then stay tuned for that. But right now I'm about to change and start working out. It's almost 8:45. I start working out at 9 o'clock, so I'm just gonna do that. Hey guys, just got done with my workouts. I just thought I'll show you my shower routine anyway. So I'm washing my hair today. I'm going in with my Mira shampoo. That's a shampoo I use very, very regularly. Then I'm just using the OGX Argan Hair Oil Conditioner. But now for the main part, which is Body Shard Gel. So Plum Body Loving has come out with new Body Shard Gels, Body Mist, and Body Lotions. So first I just want to say a few points about the brand. The brand is all about no labels. It's full about body positivity. It's like love every inch, no matter what color, what size, what shape, no matter what. So I really like the idea, like, you know, tagline of the brand. And you know, it's 100% vegan, cruelty free brand. It is all the nasty free brand, and it is a homegrown brand, which is like really amazing. One more thing is all the product packaging is done with recycled plastic, which is amazing, right? They even take the empty bottles back from you, you know, and recycle again if you want them to.
So the fragrances are so unique and they literally feel like a holiday,
because like it gives such a holiday feeling. We are so bored sitting at home since so many months. It's so, so refreshing. And a few of the names are also like that, like, you know, this one is called Hawaiian Roomba. They have vanilla vibes. So they have two shower gels. One is Driving Me Sherry and one is Hawaiian Roomba. The shower gel has sustainably sourced acai extract, and it has olive oil as well. Even like, you know, when you're rinsing your skin, you're hydrating your skin. It's really amazing because olive oil like moisturizes your skin really, really well. Then we have two body lotions. So these are silicone free moisturizers. They're super, super moisturizing. They like, you know, it's like a cream, but it's not greasy. Like it just gets absorbed into your skin. You can massage it really well and it gets absorbed really well. And all of them have resin nut oil. It's sustainably sourced, which like hydrates your skin really well. And then next for the body mist. So they have two types in the body mist. One is vanilla vibes and the other one is oopsie daisy. The mist, I think, lasts for up to like 2 to 3 hours, like once you put it on. It's very tiny and very nice, so you know, you can put it in your purse. It's not like a huge bottle which doesn't fit, so it's like a very pocket friendly, you know, mist as well. So it has aloe vera infused in the body mist. It's really nice to see in a fragrance because aloe vera has several benefits to it. If I have to pick one favorite, then I would think vanilla vibes is my thing. I love the smell of vanilla in general also, and this one smells a lot better. The body shower, I don't think I can really pick a favorite, but maybe I think Hawaiian Roomba is something I really, really like. And in the body lotion, I've been, you know, reaching out for Driving Me Cherry more.
All the links to purchase, etc., will be in the description box.
Hi guys, so quickly running out to get some props for a video. I'm thinking I'll shoot that today. You'll see that video probably in the first week of November. So I'm going on my scooty. I don't think you guys ever saw my scooty. So this is my scooty, Swiss. Been with me since so many years. I hate driving scooty these days. I've driven scooty for so many years. Let's go. I'm currently in Archie's, searching for something I like. So I wanted to take this one, but like they don't have it in silver, so I'm trying to figure out something for the backdrop. Okay guys, I just came back home. Doesn't even look like I washed my hair. I sweat so much, it is so irritating. But yeah, I got few stuff, hopefully this will be enough. I went to so many shops, like 2-3 shops, to get like lighting, props, etc.
Alright you guys, so it has been a long day. I was like, you know, shooting, and then I got done with like the shoot like around like 7:30 or something, and I was editing again. Now it's almost 10:30, 11, and I'm about to do my night routine, and I told you I'll show it to you. So I'm here. So I take my nighttime routine very seriously. No matter how tired I am, I always do my nighttime routine. One, I have to, but two, it's just like something I do for myself at the end of the day, which like makes me feel a lot better. Now the ideal routine would be like, you know, cleansing your skin, then adding like a toner or something, and then go in with this styler as like the last step to lock in everything and like, you know, have that facial oil for the entire night for it to help repair your skin. So for cleansing my face, I'm going to use the Kama Ayurveda Rose Jasmine Face Cleanser. Now this cleanser has really good hydrating ingredients plus really gentle surfactants, which is always something I look for in a cleanser. So it has glycerin, it has aqua, aloe vera juice. Aloe vera juice is literally the second ingredient, which means like, you know, it's like on a higher percentage, which is really good, especially if you have acne prone skin. And it has salicylic acid. It's really low, but it is there, so which means it's gently going to exfoliate your pores, and that's really nice to have in like, you know, a cleanser. Salicylic acid is really nice. So next I go in with toners. So according to me, rose water is a really good toner. For me, I have two categories for toners. One is a toner like you drench your skin for other like serums to penetrate into your skin really well, and the other one is an exfoliating toner. So for the drenching one, rose water works perfectly for me, and I'm using the Kama Ayurveda rose water. So I nicely just cover my entire face. So ideally the next step would be like moisturizer, and then you add in the Miracle Night Kumkumadi Thailam from Kama Ayurveda. So I've been using this Thailam for like the past few weeks, and it has helped a lot in like, you know, especially I'm a person, though I have oily skin, I have dehydrated skin, and I usually have like, you know, a little bit of flaky skin here and there. So, you know, doing this, making my skin really nice and plump, I don't feel like dehydrated as much, which is like a really good thing. So the Kumkumadi Thailam reduces pigmentation. It is a really good anti-aging oil as well. It just brightens your skin, reduces all the blemishes. So yeah, I'll see you tomorrow. Okay guys, so the thing which we did in the bedroom did not work out, so I set it up in my balcony. This shit took so much time, but yeah, I need little more light, so my dad is going out to get that. Why is it zooming? But yeah, yesterday was a boring day. I just like worked out and edited. That's all I did yesterday, and I posted the video really late last night. So yeah, today is Tuesday, and since morning again I've been editing. But now I'm currently going to my house, which is on a top floor. I was getting renovated, so I just thought I'll show you guys, give you an update of how the house is. I think it'll be done maybe in one more month finally, but I just have a mask on because there are a lot of workers there. So this is how the house is. We actually have two entrances now because there's some vast issue. That used to be our main door, but now we have two main doors. And this is our guest room. So basically I'm going to have my vanity right here, and this is all going to be white. So basically this room is going to have this material on the cupboards. It's like a marble finish. It's very shiny, it's very nice, looks very beautiful. And my entire vanity is just going to be white. So this is actually my room. This is actually the balcony door, that's the main entrance. They're working. This whole side is going to be woodwork. Like the hall is completely filled with all the work. This is actually the white sheet for my vanity. This is like that white acrylic. It doesn't have any shine because it's inverted. I'm going to like start filming there. So basically this is going to be the studio. This is like lights here. I'm going to make that a backdrop. There's a very huge ass window in this room, which gives a lot of lighting. Now this, like, it's been raining since so long, and all the woodwork is getting like, you know, wet. So we just put this here, but a lot of things got wet. So I'm about to film. I set up my ring light and my like camera. I have to take a few B-rolls, and I have one more video to film, so hopefully I'll film that. The sun is going down, so I need to like move quick. And there is one more thing I need to do, just like to do an audition tape. So weird, I can't act for shit, but then my manager, like, yeah, actually I have a manager,
I didn't tell anybody, I think. I have a manager since the past 2 months, from July, August. So, yeah. Anyway, so there's, I'm supposed to take an audition tape. It's for something. I cannot tell you, obviously. But I don't have any hopes for that. But my manager is like, you know, why not try it and send it? So, like, okay, cool. I'm gonna try. And yeah, after I shoot this, I'll just, like, you know, wear a little bit of makeup and probably shoot that.
So my lehenga for Dasara just came in. The Instagram page will be here. Such a sweet girl. She's my friend, actually. She has a designer page as well, so the name will be right here. Ignore all that. It's not my room. It's very messy. It's not our house. But yeah, the lehenga just came in. It's a really pretty. The fitting is so beautiful.
Hi guys, good morning. Hopefully you can listen to me through the mask. But I'm heading out right now to run a few errands. My friend has come to pick me up. So I'm just going there, all covered, so many things, water bottle, etc. Because outside, water, we don't know what is there. Hi, buddy.
I bought a couple of things, I'll just show you. So I told you my sister's birthday is tomorrow, that's 24th. So I just bought a couple of things for her. Like new clothes. I actually wanted to order online, but it's too late and the delivery thing is taking too long. So I just went out, so I ran into like a shop and I got a couple of things. Just went into Max and I got this shirt. So she never wears shirts. It's usually like collar t-shirts, but it's like a birthday. So I just wanted to try something new for her. So I just got this, you know, collared shirt, really nice color. Then another basic t-shirt. This is like a her everyday t-shirt. Got her pants also, like, you know, track pants. These are like capri pants, so because she's really short, so I cannot buy her full length pants. So this, I just bought this like so that it'll match with this. And then I stopped at like a, what do you say, sports shop or like gym shop, and I bought this mat. So a lot of people recommended Aerofit, so I bought this one. This one I got this for like 1600. I don't know what is the MRP, like a little bargain. I think I paid a lot for it, but yeah, if it's gonna be good quality, then I don't mind. Bond up, Rulika.
Five minutes, Rusko.
Kotta Nirke na?
Cloud.
Vale? Manchile da?
Same.
Etlundi, Rulika? Chundi. Kina da ni pant, kotta pant. Repuni birthday na? My mom didn't like the shirt.
Hello. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to your Rulika. Happy birthday to you.
Good girl, Rulika.
Slow.
Wow. It's a little bit. It's a little bit. It's a little bit. Nama. So we came to our village for the festival. I just took bath, like did little work, and yeah, I'll show you guys around after I eat a little bit. But my village house is really nice. It's really beautiful. It's a really big house, and usually we always used to come here as like a kid when I until like my, I would say 12th standard, but like my grandfather passed away and my 12th standard, so after that he stopped like coming so regularly because my daddy only comes there. But now we are here. The only thing I hate about this village is lizards. There's lizards everywhere. It freaks the hell out of me. But yeah, this is the house. I'll show you like the house in a minute. But let's go eat. So dasara for us is like puri and mutton. It is so yummy. My nanama, like my dadi, makes the best mutton in this entire world. Especially mutton during Diwali hit, like dasara hits something different. I don't know what it is, but yeah, it's I think almost done. So I'm going to eat now and I'm going to enjoy it. So puri and mutton plus Sprite used to be like the dasara thing, but like I don't obviously have Sprite now. And I'm just going to have puri and mutton.
Puri and mutton.
Oi! Hello, I cruise it now. Puri and mutton is here. So yummy. So damn yummy. I can't even, like, this mutton is. Is it just me? Or anybody else who can't have onion is fine, but I can't have non-veg without lemon. I always have to have lemon for non-veg. Just got ready and took a few pictures on the terrace. My dad took the picture.
Yeah, let's start with a tour, and this is like the entrance, and here we have like a huge lawn. Like hopefully you'll see the pictures I'll take here like by the time I post this video. And that bird nest, bro, there are two nests here too. So the birds keep coming in and going out from that. So cute. And imagine my daddy takes care of all of this. And there is me. And yeah, that's it. Like there's nothing like you surrounded four sides with the same thing. You know how villages are, like there has to be a washroom outside. There's washroom inside as well. Pretty much it. And yeah, pretty much a tour. We have a papaya tree here. Kacha yet, no fruits yet. You guys, my dad just went out and came. Meanwhile they dug that and our car is stuck, like literally the bumper is gone. Oh shit, bro, it's not like they're trying to remove it, but finally.
Although I didn't do anything, it's a relief that it is out. I was just taking a video, obviously. I mean, like, there's so many people there. Thank God it's off. But the bumper is completely gone. So, probably, like, once we return to Hyderabad, we'll have to get the car repaired. Which is sad. But at least it's, like, not a lot of damage. I'm in my PJs, don't mind. But I just wanted to show you this one last thing. So this is for people who actually live in, like, you know, Telugu people or Andhra and Telangana people. So when you go from Hyderabad to Vijayawada, there's a village called Narketpally. Basically, that's our village. And on the way, you can find a petrol bunk, which is basically my dad's. So it's like two things. One is a bypass and one is a village road. I think it'll open towards the bypass also. But right now, when you go through the village, you'll find this petrol bunk. Basically, if you, like, you know, this is the village road. And this is the bunk and that side is the bypass. I think they'll connect it soon. We don't know yet. But you know, this is the petrol bunk. They have my name for it. And this is the bunk. So my dad is here sometimes. Like if you pass by, you can fill your petrol bunk here. Yesterday I was planning on taking photos here. We just stopped here because he has some work. We are returning right now. And but yeah, I think I'll end my vlog here. If you happen to pass this, then do send me photos, I think.
So basically, it's right opposite to Kamineni Hospital.
She is also all ready, set, go. Bye.
Bye.